music has always been a huge part of Welsh culture, but it's not all male voice choirs and harps. It's also indie rock, pop punk, rap, metal, and even opera. Wales has so much to offer the world of music, and in 1999, the BBC named it Cool Cymru, a movement of Welsh musicians uprising, with favourites such as the Manic Street Preachers, Stereophonics, and Super Furry Animals. Cool Cymru rose through the charts, and Wales was recognised for its variety of musical talent. When the label Cool Cymru caught on, it was viewed as its own music scene. I spoke to music fan Geraint Jones to hear his perspective of the different music scenes at the time of Cool Cymru.
I don't remember it being called Cool Cymru, but having said that, I don't remember glam rock being called glam rock when it was around. Manchester had been called that either when Stone Roses and all that kicked off. So I think things like Cool Cymru come later when these scenes get going and people start to sort of put it all together. I mean, at the time, you know, there's probably years between the Manics and the Phonics and coming into play. So it could be the case that, you know, when people look back and they're all going, they start giving it these labels which stick forever then.
Cool Cymru wasn't the only growing movement of the time. Britpop and rave culture also developed massively, with bands such as Blur, The Happy Mondays and The Prodigy. Although these emerging genres were constantly bringing out new music, the bands representing Cool Cymru already had a huge repertoire dating back years before the likes of Oasis and Fatboy Slim. The Manic Street Preachers are one of the most significant bands that earned the Cool Cymru title. Formed in 1986, Manic Street Preachers led the way into Cool Cymru years after their beginning. I spoke to Manics fan Terry Griffiths to hear his opinions on the Manics and Cool Cymru.
I enjoy all the Manics careers, but I mean, they've gone through that many genres of ideas and political awareness that I like most of it, but I'd say in the early 90s, late 90s, 2000s, that was the best era.
Do you think that Cool Cymru started with the Manics?
Not specifically then, no. I think it was a coming together of all Welsh bands at that certain amount of time.
Do you think that Cool Cymru was already happening before it got the name Cool Cymru?
Yeah, I agree with that. It was a coming together of all these Welsh bands at the same time, the Stereophonics, your Catatonias, the Manics, Super Furry Animals. It was just accumulation of all of them at that certain moment in time.
Do you think it was just a case of the right place and the right time for Welsh musicians?
Yes, definitely.
To find out more about Cool Cymru's past and possible return, I spoke to BBC Radio Wales programme host Adam Walton.
I'm Adam Walton. I've been working for BBC Radio Wales since 1993. And I started my first programme. All of the radio programmes that I've done were, in essence, programmes to kind of celebrate Welsh music. Back then, it was much harder to do because there was so little Welsh music about and being released. So literally, you put together a two-hour programme and maybe four or five tracks within, and that 2 hours would be of Welsh origin. And now we do a three-hour programme every week, and I could fill three times that with really, really fine new Welsh music. So it's a marked difference. 1997, 1998 was when that phrase was being used by the press, and it was a phrase that just kind of curdled, really, because it made what was quite a disparate and really interesting country full of music sound like it was a scene, something quite reductive, and something quite jingoistic as well. And you know, bands like Super Furry Animals especially were very outward looking. They were really interested in an international perspective. So although incredibly proud, I'm sure, to be Welsh, it was more about looking outwards. And I think that my problem with Cool Cymru has always been that it tended to focus on the most obvious bands, and it and there was a jingoism to it that I don't think necessarily matched what was truly fascinating about the music of Super Furries or Gorkies or 60 Foot Dolls or Dub War or any of the bands that weren't really grouped with it but had to tolerate the phraseology. I think if you asked Keris or Mark from Catatonia about that now. It was just something that happened around them. It wasn't anything that they kind of encouraged. So anyway, things are very different now. What's different now is that there's just an awful lot more music being made by an awful lot more people, and no one has to apologise for being Welsh. Being Welsh isn't something that's kind of derided or taken the piss out of across the border. We know which border I'm talking about. And Welsh music is celebrated like all other music is, on its merits, which is a much healthier situation. And obviously Welsh music covers such a broad span of sounds and expression, as it does in any other country. We shouldn't be surprised by that. You couldn't define or determine Welsh music by a particular sound or anything like that. It's just country. It's music that happens to come from a country with a great kind of geographical variety, which I think is one of the things that feeds into that. The other thing is now, people are a lot more open-minded, I think, and inclusive, and that's really important because a lot of the variety within Welsh music is down to the fact that everyone contributes. So, you know, we're talking at Focus Wales. Focus Wales has got a very diverse booking policy across Welsh artists from all different backgrounds, all different cultures. We've had Hemas, who's from an Arabic background, playing for us tonight, and then the likes of Mace the Great and Andrew Ogan, and just remarkable artists, like I say, from all different kinds of cultural perspectives, as it were. And it's just brilliant to reflect that.
After covering the history of Cool Cymru, I took to Wrexham-based music and arts festival Focus Wales. Hundreds of musicians travel from all over the world to take part in this three-day event. Welsh bands play alongside Canadian, German, Mongolian and many more diverse bands to bring music lovers together. At the festival, I met Welsh musician Mark Huckridge, who gave me an insight on his views of Cool Cymru and the Welsh pop music scene.
Okay, so I'm Mark Huckridge. I'm a musician from Wales, from Wrexham, North Wales. Yeah, so I play in a band called Gallops, also make solo music, and yeah, it's been pretty good. I've been doing that since about 2007, and toured the world with it, so that's pretty cool, sort of taking Welsh music abroad, and I've met a lot of other great musicians along the way, sort of hopefully kind of put Wrexham and North Wales on the map in some ways, in places, so that's sort of... Makes me feel quite proud of being from here, I guess. Yeah.
Do you think Cool Cymru could happen again?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think it is happening. You know, I think, obviously we're at Focus Wales Festival at the moment. It's one of the biggest industry events in the country. There's a lot of cool Welsh artists out at the moment as well, that are sort of making waves around the world. Some to mention Over Mono, Kelly Lee Owens, like big artists that are making me proud of being Welsh.
Another Welsh band performing at Focus Wales this year was Hazmat. The Wrexham-based band formed in 2021 and signed to Anvil Records in September. The alternative grunge rock band agreed to be filmed as part of this documentary over the course of 3 months, to witness their progress in becoming the next best Welsh band. I was invited to one of many rehearsals in RPM Studios in Liverpool to watch them prepare for their first headline gig in England, which took place in Manchester Academy in April. The gig was a huge success in showcasing their latest single, Stay Away, which I was lucky enough to catch in the rehearsal before its release on the 1st of April. As members of a Welsh rock band, Dan and Jim were eager to share their views of Welsh popular music and give me an insight of what it's like to be in an up-and-coming Welsh band.
I'm James, and I play drums for Hazmat.
And I'm Dan, and I play lead guitar for Hazmat.
We're both from Wrexham.
Is being Welsh important to you as a band?
Yeah,
I'd say definitely it's a massive part of the way we market ourselves as a Welsh band. I think it's important to stay true to that.
Do you think it's important for other bands to express their nationality?
Definitely, yeah. Especially if you're from Wales.
Yeah.
Why especially if you're from Wales?
I started to think this ever since the success we had in the Euros. I think being from Wales has just got that extra bit of heart and a bit of more...
It's like an underdog mentality.
Yeah, underdog mentality.
With everything, with education, with football, with music, with rugby, with everything.
It just seems like there's a lot more passion with Welsh people about their nationality than anywhere else I've seen.
Do you think your nationality has any impact on your success?
No, I wouldn't say so. Because, especially what we do, it's about the tunes, really. If the tunes are good, it doesn't really matter where you're from.
Music's kind of an anomaly, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you want to achieve as a band?
Especially ever since we've had a flavour for it at the beginning of the year, touring as a band is just the best part. Obviously, making the music and recording it and releasing music for people to hear is great, but touring is just...
Just doing what we love as often as possible.
What are your methods of getting out there to do that?
I think playing live is definitely the most effective way of getting yourself out there, because you can spend hours on social media campaigns and all that sort of stuff, which we've done plenty of. But then the whole thing is anything quite the same as getting that experience from watching a live band.
Do you take any inspiration for your music from other Welsh musicians?
Yeah, definitely. Seeing other Welsh bands come up through the scene, if you like, especially from Wrexham, like Neck Deep, like the story of that, is every Welsh band that's from Wrexham has been spoken to about there, or it's like spoke about Neck Deep, you know what I mean? Like, or just
and other like bands a like colossal that. Band in America now.
Yeah, exactly.
And even like our mates, the Royston Club, like they've just gone to Osters, played South by Southwest, and it's just like crazy. I'd like to think that bands can see what we're doing and think, like, especially like if you're a band from Wrexham, it's quite hard to get into that. It's quite hard to get into the circuit, but if you can see bands like us doing it, then I hope that does inspire other bands to do the same.
Do you think that the Cool Cymru movement could happen again?
The way things are at the moment, I think definitely there's so many bands and artists coming up through the scene at the moment, so, and they're all brilliant, so I can't see why it couldn't happen again.
Do you think it could already be happening?
Possibly, yeah.
Yeah, possibly. I don't think that Welsh musicians, I don't think Welsh bands get as much coverage, because, I mean, I'd like to do really well at the moment, but other than that, I don't think there's any in the charts or album charts or anything like that I can see, but not probably since Catfish.
Yeah.
But it definitely could be happening.
Who are some of your favourite Welsh bands that you think could contribute to the next movement?
Meanus are brilliant. They're so the good.
Royston Club.
Yeah, the Royston Club are doing very well at the moment.
Bandicoot, Panic Shark. There's loads. So many. Gallops.
There is an abundance of fantastic Welsh bands that could definitely contribute.
Since joining Hazmat at their rehearsal in March, the band's social media promotions reached over 7,000 people through Instagram, resulting in over 1,500 new followers. As Cool Cymru returns, bands like Hazmat have social media on their side, a tool that original Cool Cymru bands lacked. Not only could Cool Cymru be coming back, it comes with diversity, accessibility and longevity we have never seen before in the Welsh music scene. Wales has more to offer than ever before, and for bands like Hazmat, this is only the start of it. Wales has more to offer than ever before, and for bands like Hazmat, this is only the start of it.